because I know you guys are coming to Camino this May. But so we'll just take a little tour of the Piedmont region of Italy. Piedmont is in the northern part of Italy, very near the Alps. So it's a cooler climate than, say, Tuscany. And they're famous for the area called Barbaresco, if you guys have heard of Barbaresco, as well as Barolo. And those are two very prestigious growing areas. The grape is Nebbiolo, which we'll talk a little bit more about. But so they're mostly known for Barbaresco and Barolo, the area of Piedmont, which ironically only accounts for about 3% of the production of the wine. So there's lots of other fun grapes that are grown in the area, like Barbera, Dolcetto, there's the whites, Gavi, things like that. You might have heard of Scato di Asti or what's the other one? The other sparkling.
Prosecco?
Well, no, that's elsewhere. No, that's... No, that's not Piedmont. Sorry. Sorry, that's a little bit of a different area. Anyway, so, yeah, so they've got some really great growing regions besides the Barbaresco and Barolo area. Super, very different. How many people have been to Piedmont? Has anyone been to Piedmont? Okay, how about Tuscany? Yeah, okay, so Tuscany's right. That's everything that's Tuscany. Tuscany, a very different, when we think of Italian food and Italian wine, most of us go to Tuscany, right? Tomatoes, basil, olives, olive oil. Piedmont is not that. I've never been to Tuscany, but I have been to Piedmont, and it was my first trip to Italy, and we got off the plane, traveled into, we were in Alba, actually, and went to a restaurant, and I was like, where's the olive oil? We're in Italy. Why is there not olive oil on the table? So being a stupid American, I asked for olive oil, and they looked at me like, oh, okay, yeah, whatever, and they put it on the table. What I realized is that olive trees don't grow in Piedmont. So they actually grow cattle. So they use butter as their main fat, not olive oil. They also are, no, that's fine.
Sorry.
No, I apologize. So other famous food items from Piedmont are figs. They grow tons of figs. Hazelnuts, you guys have heard of Nutella? Oh my gosh, the Nutella, the factory is in the town of Alba, which I stayed in, and every morning I would wake up and the entire town smelled like Nutella. Crazy. It was crazy. So hazelnuts, figs, truffles. The truffle mushrooms, super famous for that, right? Very expensive truffle mushrooms. So there's a lot of really fun foods that are grown in that area. Like I said, very different. So the first wine that we're going to try is actually a white. This is Scovino. We have two wines of Scovino tonight.
No, we're
this is a really cool fun blend of Sauvignon Blanc, Chardonnay, and Viognier, which are not really Italian grape varietals. But the family has been making wine for a long time. The winery was established in 1921. And Paulio Scovino, which is the winery is named after, started making wine with his dad, working full time at the winery with his dad when he was 10 years old in 1951. So he's been working the vineyard at the winery since he was 10. He's definitely grown up since then. He's had two beautiful daughters, Elise and Enrica, I think is her name, and they have taken over the winery. So this is a female winemaker, Elisa, who is just awesome, very passionate about what she does, and really studied hard, not just in Piedmont, but in other wine-growing areas of the world, so very knowledgeable. So anyway, are we going to do salads, or do you want to pour first?